Hello friends, welcome to Macnotech YouTube channel. Friends, in previous video we have seen about the slip gauge, right? How to use slip gauge with using the sine bar. Okay, so I have discussed little bit about the sine bar. So in this video we are going to see for the angular measuring instruments, it is called the sine bar. So here you can see these are the angular measuring instruments in which we are going to discuss about sine bar today, right? So you can see here it is a very important questions too, right? So slip gauge can be used for the measurement of angle with the help of simple piece apparatus known as a sine bar. So you can see here this is a sine bar, right? Now this sine bar is a hardened steel beam mounted on two hardened equal diameter, you can see here, this is an equal diameter cylinder at known distance. Like here, center of this cylinder to center of this cylinder, distance is around 100 mm. Not around, but exactly 100 mm. Distance between these two center is 100 mm, right? So, to make it lighter and facilitate handling, the holes are drilled on it as shown in figure. So here you can see this is a hole drilled on it for making it like lighter. It can be used for in a various form according to the method of application we will see later and the purpose of its use. Okay, so here you can see the distance between cylinder axis are 100 mm, 200 mm, 300 mm in the metric system and 5 inches or 10 inches in a British system, right? And this distance plays an important role while manufacturing all the parts of the sine bar. Okay, now principle of operation, how we can use the sine bar, right? So as shown in figure, now you can see the figure, right? So in particular this figure, this is a slip gauges, right? From the ground level, whatever the inclination of any object, we have to arrange slip gauges in that manner. Okay, we have to add the slip gauges in particular like 30, 20, whatever slip gauges we can add over here. And this distance is fixed, L. It means center distance is fixed, right? And we know the height of slip gauge because we have already used it and the measurement also written on the slip gauge. So we know this height. So if we know this height and length, then we can easily measure this angle theta. So sine theta is equal to, we can write it is h by l, right? Sine theta is equal to h by l. So by this way we can measure the angle theta, right? So nothing is new for this sine bar and slip gauge. This is a basic operation for the sine bar and slip gauge for measuring the angle theta. Now here different applications given for sine bar. Say here sine bar with using the dial gauge, right? Sine bar with using the standoff dial gauge, you can see here. Another one here, sine bar used with the vernier height gauge. So you can see here, this is a vernier height gauge, and by using vernier height gauge we can also measure the angle. Okay, so this is another application. Here you can see this is a sine bar used with the dial indicator, right, for measuring the angle. So by different way of using sine bar given, and basically then you need to write only these things about sine bar, and this is the principal operation by using sine bar and slip gauge. So I hope you understand these things, and if you like this, press like button, share this video to your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.